Hi guys, we really appreciate your support and encouragement for MKK YouTube channel. Lecture series is back here with you. Topic we have selected it is supply chain management. Today our expert is going to talk about it. So here we go. Supply chain management is a very vast subject. And its importance and value can never be overruled. To understand it in a better way, let's focus and understand its definition. It's a process of planning, organizing, and controlling the flow of materials and supplies from suppliers towards the end users, which are the customers or any reliable resources through which the material management has been done. There are many ways through which it takes place. There are procedures being developed, and the supply chain management therefore becomes a complete set of ideas, set of strategies through which it is being taken care in any organization. There are three to four levels which are there. The level 1, 2 and 3, and then the basic level. So once we see it in detail, we would be able to understand that how these levels work. Basically the relationship which is focused is between demand supply is needed, and vice versa it goes, like from one thing to the other, like there is demand, so the supply is to be done according to the need and requirement. In simple words to understand is that what is the demand, what is the requirement, vice versa. Like there are about the product, which what is the category, what type of, how much, like quantity we speak about, the quality we speak about. This is how the demand and supply works while we speak of supply chain management. So performance is increased speed, improved quality and reduced cost. Whoever is going to go for the good product, obviously a person is going to monitor the quality, and the cost effectiveness is also focused. There are objectives which are need to minimize pre and post production, provide flexible planning and control mechanism, and minimizing the transport cost. Obviously, once the product is to be transported to the desired place, including the product cost and everything, the thing is to be monitored well. Like you have to focus all these objects, tracking the inventory, then to deliver it to the right place. Strategies of supply chain management, one of the very important area which we need to understand and then keep our focus on it, because planning is needed. Once you have got a strategy made, then only you can implement it both. To keep one thing focused, that why is a supply chain strategy so important? Like we speak about it, we say that the inventory is to be maintained, the cost is to be measured, is to be kept in mind. So we need to know this. To answer this, there is a very simple thing to understand. Focus on which supply chain management strategies depend. Understand this includes distributor centers, then cross docking and third party logistics, information technology, where and what do you need to deliver and to make on this. Then developing a supply chain strategy, there are few points which we need to understand: the business strategy and supply chain, and keep communicating with your partners. For that matter, only once we proceed in this field, we need to understand the few other things. While we speak of challenges, the first challenge is the lack of ownership, then communication within organization and communication with the external suppliers. While you are making contracts or you are speaking about other factors, it's very important to have good communication skills, which does include negotiations. Then role of IT in supply chain management strategies is very important. It can never be overlooked. Keep records of raw materials, then information about the goods, and keep the details about the traders, etc., with whom you are dealing. Software vendors of the supply chain management is very important, like SAP, which shortly few people say as SAP, but whereas it is to be pronounced as SAP accounts, or we can have any of the system which is going to help you through software. So the role of IT is basically information is key to supply chain. So that information is so crucial to supply chain performance that IT servers are the eyes and ears of the management of supply chain. So to keep that focused and interactive, you need to understand that the goals of supply chain IT are to be reflected and very clearly understood. Once the information is collected, so the analysis is based on some supply chain data and collaboration with the supply chain partners, which are vendors of, is to be maintained in a very effective. I have considered as a case study Dell, so I'm gonna more speak about it as a example. So it is very important that the manufacturing industry or wherever the supply chain is concerned, we need to know the basics. Let's suppose the case study Dell. Dell mantra is better, fast and cheaper. So these focused by this organization, so the supply chain is completely developed this thought. So based on it, how do they do? They have got golden rules. Always listen to the customer and never sell indirect. So only with their dealers or with their customers, so that they exactly know that what the requirement is. Even if design thinking process is involved, they'll go with that also. So the focus becomes globalization and the problem areas. At times the communication is not directly being done, rather, or the globalization is going on the other, depending on the trends which are there. So basically, while you are speaking to their strategy or other strategy, the only thing which matters the most is to collaborate with all the requirements. Then cost comes, and obviously the services come, which are to be considered while we speak in coming up lectures in detail about all these aspects. Then technology, supply chain management, electronic data interchange, that matters a lot. Again, I would say which are established based on IT base, IT data based, whether for the supply chain process is really affected in a good sense while we are interacting in a very you can say professional manner, and utilizing the software for the follow up and for making the deals done in a very authentic way. So for that, obviously we need to know that the internet is one of the base thing, and then the identifications are also very important, so that the process through the softwares goes in accordance with that. So this is just a model example in front of how it works. It's obviously the main source of everything is customer or your dealer or the vendor for whom you are the supply, and this is how the supply chain management works. I have kept one small example of that how this process is there. I have shared one small screen, but the next upcoming lecture is completely based on the details which I have just highlighted over here. One single topic you will be finding in coming up videos, so that you can focus and help yourself. This is one of the screenshot of the SAP which we are doing for our own classes which are conducted here in the institute and are benefited for the college classes also. So SAP, like I said, is another effective. If there are other softwares also available. Thank you guys for watching. Upcoming is contract management, negotiation skills and vendor management. Also this clip is in detail in upcoming videos, so subscribe and wait for the next video. Take care, bye bye.